Hey y'all, good evening. It is your girl Desiree, and I wanted to come on here and do this video for y'all. Welcome back to my channel. If you are new to my channel, please hit that subscribe button, turn on your post notifications, give this video a thumbs up, and comment down below if you are know someone who can relate, or if you are possibly in the same situation as I am. So I decided to do this video because I was watching another YouTube video, and I wanted to be, like, in my life, I have always wanted to be transparent with other people. Excuse my hair. Okay. I've always wanted to be transparent. I don't ever want to live in a lie. I don't ever want to live in the shadows. I don't ever want to have people come and try to figure me out and make assumptions about me or lie about me and say things that are not true. So, currently, as you guys know and can see, your girl is overweight, okay? I think I'm considered more morbidly obese, but I'm not over 400 pounds. I am in the 300s. I have a lot of physical limits that prevent me from holding down a job. Sometimes I have a social life and sometimes I don't. The reason why I'm telling y'all this is because my life is kind of dull. My life is not, it's not where I can, my life is like I can't get up and do what a normal person can do. Okay, for instance, my mom is in her 60s and she has two jobs, and she can get up and work 16 to 18 hours a day, where my limitations are extremely hard for me. Washing the dishes, sweeping the floor, taking a shower, doing my laundry is extremely hard. Right now, some of you guys may know who are subscribed to my channel. Maybe you know, maybe you do know, maybe you don't know, but I'm gonna fill you in. I have arthritis in my knees, which means the cartilage in my left knee is gone. So it's bone on bone. My right knee is becoming worse. Okay. I have arthritis in my spine, and it's like a degenerative deformity is what they called it. I had an MRI done of my spine and my left knee, and I was in the MRI for 2 hours. I struggle every day. Every day is a struggle for me, okay? So I also have fibromyalgia, and that within itself is a very combative with the fact that I am type 2 diabetic. Most days I don't want to get out of bed. Most days I stay in my pajamas all day. So now I live in my own place, and I was living with my mom for almost 4 years, and I couldn't support myself. I'm not crying because I want y'all to feel sorry for me. I'm crying because I had to depend upon my mom for everything. And my sister. My sister was like, don't worry about it. I'll help you, you know, I'll help you. I was able to come into my own money, y'all. I'll just put it that way. And okay, so if I go grocery shopping or any shopping, walking around the store for me, it is a complete struggle. I look normal, okay? If you would look at me, and the only thing you would guess is, okay, you're overweight, you're plus size, you're a BBW. Anything else, you would not know by looking at me that I have disabilities going on, because I don't show it unless you literally see me trying to be active. So I deal with depression. I might have anxiety. I think I might have insomnia. I'm telling y'all, like, my life is a constant struggle every single second of every single day. When I was staying with my mom, everything I tried to do, I tried to get a job. I applied for like 40 different jobs. That's an exaggeration, but nobody would hire me. When I did get a job, I worked at the Dollar Tree, and the shifts were only 4 hours. I couldn't handle it. I was in tears, and the pain was horrible. It was horrible. About time I would get done with my shifts, like, I could barely walk. I would make so many mistakes because my pain was horrific. Y'all, this is embarrassing for me, because sometimes I feel like I'm not good enough, like I'm not worthy of happiness. Sometimes I feel like I'm struggling. I mean, I'm not talking about, like, I'm talking about a mental struggle, like a... I'm talking about a struggle. There's people who care about me, and there's people who don't give a damn about me. So when I tell you guys that I want you guys to know my life, I can't tell y'all everything, but I can tell you some things. I appreciate the people who have continuously supported me. My sister, oh my God. Y'all, my sister was always encouraging me to take it day by day, and she was always telling me just to pray and ask God for strength. Yeah, at times that seemed hard because I didn't know like what I can endure. I have a lot of people praying for me, and I'm very appreciative of that. And every day is a blessing for me. But I know I can get up and do things, actively do things for myself. Y'all can't even begin to understand how much the pain is. Like, it's unbearable for me at times. Even right now, sitting here talking to y'all, like,
I'm in pain right now. And I'm just like really overwhelmed because I don't want you guys to be like, dang, she's so miserable and this and that or whatever. I'm not miserable. I'm always exhausted. I'm always tired. I'm trying to stay positive. I'm trying to stay focused. There's a lot of things that I struggle with, like as far as what I eat on a daily basis. I even drink apple cider vinegar with water so that I can keep my system regular. And it actually helps. It's nasty, but it helps me. I try to journal regularly. I try to journal regularly. I do a Bible writing plan monthly, and I'm pretty sure if you guys have seen those previous vlogs that I've done before, or videos, excuse me. That's what helps me staying in the word, listening to Christian music, gospel music. That's what helps me. My daughters, my son are very supportive of me, and they're always telling me not to give up. They're always telling me to be strong, and my daughter's always telling me, Mom, you can do it. And I'm thankful for my kids. I really am. I'm thankful for the people who have helped me. I befriended a lady, and during my counseling days, and she helped me move, and she's super, super, like, she's always there for me when I need her for anything, and I couldn't ask for anything better than the support that I have right now. I'm just telling y'all, if you know anyone who is struggling with chronic pain, don't be rude. Don't be mean to them. You know, it's not about what you can give them. It's about how you can uplift them. It's about how you can say, you know what, I'm here for you. Just tell me what you need me to do. And I try to be there for other people as much as I can, because I know that my words and the things that I do can encourage other people. I'm not bound to my bed. No, that's one thing that I'm so happy about. I've watched My 600-Pound Life, and I've seen so many of their episodes. And I watched a lot of the seasons of the show. And that's the one thing that I really, really do not want to be is bedridden. Because I know that would further put me in a bad predicament, and I'm not trying to be bedridden. But at the same time, it's like I literally have to force myself. I have to push myself to get up and be somewhat active throughout the day. I'm trying to get back into the gym where I could take water aerobics, and that's the best thing for me. So I'm hoping probably the beginning of March I can be able to do that, so that way I can become more active. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Make sure you give this video a thumbs up. Comment down below. I welcome the bad. I welcome.